By the end of the video, you're going to see that two out of those three individuals, they actually agree, despite the moronic comments left in Derek's thread. Coach Greg, and today we're settling the debate. Should you eat protein before bed? So, who's right? Jeremy Ethier, Coach Greg, or Derek from Plate for Dates? Before starting the video, let me tell you my opinion of Jeremy. He's more spews for more views. He tells you what you want to hear, not what you need to hear. When he does tell the truth and when he does provide scientific information, most of you don't bother watching it. So he clickbaits titles, tells you exciting promises. He clickbait titles so that you'll watch the videos. Some of them are scientific, but some he misinterprets the data.
It appears that you need at least 40 grams of protein to get a significant increase in overnight muscle protein synthesis.
But did Jeremy misinterpret this data? The data that he says you need to have protein before bed. In the study Jeremy's referring to, they're training at 8 p.m. Not in the morning, not in the afternoon, in the evening. So can you just say that just because you train at night and need protein after, that that applies to if you're training in the morning? No, of course not. And think of it. I'm almost a 200-pound bodybuilder. Am I going to only eat 20 grams of protein four times a day? If so, obviously eating 40 grams before bed is going to help. I need more protein. So it's not the nutrient timing, but the total protein that's making the difference. And what about Derek? What's Derek's opinion? Did Derek actually say you shouldn't eat protein before bed? That it has no benefit? That you won't help you build muscle? And is Coach Greg, is he just a con artist who lies to you to make money? Well, let's watch the video and find out. But first, let's read some of the comments in the comments section. He is like a non-screaming version of Coach Greg. I actually think that's quite accurate. He's a lot like Coach Greg, except he doesn't scream and shout. Calls out the bullshit, gives you scientific information that makes sense. Explains it in such a way that the people can understand. So I agree with that comment. But what about the rest of these comments? Well, Greg actually said that you need protein before bed. Absolutely, I said that. And I'm sticking by it. You should be eating protein before bed. You have 4 to 5 opportunities for muscle protein synthesis to occur. You shouldn't eat all your protein in a specific window. You shouldn't intermittent fast. If you want to maximize muscle hypertrophy, you should be eating meals with protein spread out throughout the day. Greg Doucette is a piece of shit con man. Me? I thought that was Paige Hathaway or Shaquille O'Neal or V-Shred. I didn't know I was that. Learn something new every day. With facts too, LOL. Greg just gives you his opinion. A less annoying Coach Greg. I mean, I got to agree. He's a less annoying version of Coach Greg who doesn't scream and shout. That's how I see him. Literally nothing like Greg. One person says Coach Greg and Derek are a lot alike. The other says nothing alike. So more plates, more dates writes, this is about backloading your daily protein allotment right before bed versus not backloading. Derek is not saying to not eat any protein before bed. He's saying, don't hold back on eating all your protein earlier in the day to eat a massive portion of protein right before bed. That is what he's saying. He's not saying that protein before bed is a waste of time. He's not saying, don't ever eat before bed. He's not saying protein before bed is bad, that it's going to ruin your gains. Derek's title says, Jeremy F.A. is wrong about protein before bed. Brackets. This will ruin your gains. Derek is not saying that eating protein before bed will ruin your gains.
I try to actually like do some of this stuff in my titles to see if it works better and be like, eat like this or
freaking cookbook. It's just in the title. You have to watch the video.
I already don't agree that you should be having a big protein meal before bed.
Does that sound like Derek disagrees with Coach Greg?
Second thing he says is you should literally backload it to the point where you're having a giant protein meal before bed that's substantially bigger than all your other meals.
Oh, Coach Greg said you should eat protein before bed. He's wrong because Derek said you shouldn't eat protein before bed. Or does Derek say, nobody said don't eat at all before bed if muscle growth is a goal. I would rather spread it out evenly than backload a giant portion pre-bed. In reading that, I do believe that Derek is saying if you want to build more muscle, it's probably a good idea to eat protein before bed. Just not to eat a shit ton of it and to spread out your protein meals evenly throughout the day. That is what Derek is saying. That is what Coach Greg is saying. That is not what Jeremy is saying.
That you want to also bias a little bit more of your daily protein towards this pre-sleep meal.
Jeremy is saying eat less protein throughout the day and double up on protein before bed.
In fact, research seems to agree with this. 20 grams of protein gives a near maximal increase and appears that you need at least 40 grams of protein overnight muscle protein synthesis.
The same authors state that we cannot say whether it was due to timing or the fact that they got more total protein. Do you get it now? Jeremy's making up more spews for more views. But oh, Coach Greg, no, he doesn't report on the science. He just creates drama. Or is the drama that I create due to the fact that these scientific people, the YouTubers, are misinterpreting the data, and I don't want to let them get away with it?
Today we're going to be talking about Jeremy Ethier. I don't know.
And you don't think he reminds you of Coach Greg? How often do I mispronounce names? Jeremy Ethier. Jeremy Ethier.
There was a point that came up about a third into the video that I thoroughly disagreed with that I just kind of want to rebuttal.
Does that not sound like Coach Greg? I did the freaking same thing on Jeremy Ethier more than once. I do that on tons of people. My YouTube channel is literally based on doing that. So of course, Plates for Dates and I are doing the same types of videos. We're calling out the bullshit on social media.
Although we have optimized it throughout the day, we need to keep in mind that the muscle building and recovery process still goes on overnight as you're sleeping.
And I'm so annoyed with these caricatures with the freaking cartoon, with the walk-in like this, and y'all eat it up, 3 million followers. So yeah, he's doing better than Coach Greg and Derek put together. He knows how to clickbait titles to make you watch his information. Because when he doesn't, you don't watch. He wants to make money. We all do. I want to make money. I want to sell my freaking cookbook. You ever noticed? Nothing wrong with that. But what I don't like is when they lie or misinterpret the information, the studies, and spew it to you to trick you. That is what I don't like.
It makes sense to ingest an adequate amount of protein shortly before you go to bed, since that's the longest period that you'll go without food.
So the point is made by him that you should be having a big protein meal before bed, a slow digesting one too.
So Derek doesn't think you need a big protein meal before bed.
First of all, I already don't agree that you should be having a big protein meal before bed.
That doesn't mean he thinks you should have no protein. That's what people misinterpret.
It's just like the most short-sighted analysis of a study I've ever seen. Like to just look at a study and assume, oh, you know, like you need the muscle protein synthesis around the clock is what we need.
So that's the problem. They see Derek say one thing, then they make a straw man argument and say in the comment section, oh, Derek said you shouldn't have any protein. Greg, you're wrong. You spew lies.
Like, no, dude, you need to sleep properly, and that's not going to happen if you're spiking your body temperature through the roof.
Does Coach Greg agree? Course I do. You realize in other videos I've said, if I had the choice between a sleeping pill, a sleeping aid, something to help me sleep, or a fat burner, I choose a sleeping aid anytime.
Have a giant 50 gram protein casein meal right before going to bed. Check your body temperature and then see what your sleep quality is like relative to that.
Through the digestion process, you're burning off a lot of the calories from the protein as heat. So if you're eating so much protein that it's affecting your sleep, that you're getting night sweats and you can't go to sleep, better to back off on the protein.
Which one do you think is going to recover better? It's going to be the guy who didn't backload his protein right before going to bed. So no, you don't want to be increasing your body temperature right before bed with a giant bolus of protein.
I personally eat protein in the hours before bed. Couple hours before bed, an hour before bed, I'm eating some protein. Doesn't have to be a lot. Doesn't have to be 500 or 600 or 800 calories. But by eating 4 to 5 meals a day, with one being in the evening, containing protein, it is going to help you build more muscle.
If you've seen the data on just what a couple hours of sleep lopped off of your daily, you know, sleep amount can do to your endogenous androgen production.
So, should we have protein before bed? Yes! Should we double or triple up on protein before bed? No! That's it. Settled the debate. Ending it here. GregDucette.com for coaching. GregDucette IPB Pro. Watch one of the bloops. At least one. Please watch one. Buy my freaking cookbook. Subscribe and click that bell button. Follow me on the gram and the talk. And until next time, I am out. A less annoying coach Greg.